Let's start creating to-do list application in Symphony. This is going to be CRUD application, which means create, read, update, delete. In the case of our application, create means that we are able to create a new task. Read means that we are able to display all the tasks from the database. Update means that we are able to update the task to be done or undone. And delete, which means that we are able to delete the task. As I mentioned in the theoretical part of the course, to install Symphony, we need a Composer tool. Composer is a tool for installing PHP libraries. It can be installed in two ways, locally or globally. And the second thing, we need to some server environment. In this case, I will be using xampp. With the Apache server started and MySQL server. Okay, this is the database of xampp. But here there is a xampp starting page. Here we have dashboard catalog. And if I go to the folder where I have xampp installed, this is the catalog from which the default xampp web page is shown. So I'm going to install my application here. So I'm going to open the console. Before we install Symphony, let's check if we have a Composer installed. I have Composer installed globally. So I write a Composer and check if it is installed. Also, it is worth it to check if we have the latest version of Composer installed. Composer, self-update. And now if I have Composer installed and Apache server started and MySQL database, then I can go ahead and install Symphony application. Composer, create project, Symphony skeleton, and the name of our application, which can be whatever, Symph4CRUD. I click enter, and I am waiting for the application to be installed. And the application was installed, and I see here the instruction how to run application. I am not going to use Symphony built-in server, but as I mentioned, I am going to use xampp. And here my application was installed. The server is going to look to the public folder. Here there is an index.php file. And now when I try to enter to my installed Symphony application, and here there should be obviously Symphony, because this is how I called my folder. And now, as I mentioned earlier, server is going to look to the public folder. And here I have index.php Symphony file. But I don't want such URL address. If I wanted, I could leave it like that. But I want to create here a friendly URL. To do this, I need to create virtual host. So now I'm going to create it. Of course, depending on server environment, creating virtual host may look different. I have xampp installed. When it comes to xampp, the file for creating virtual host, in my case, in Linux, is located in folder opt-lamp-etc. And virtual hosts I create in the following file. httpd hosts. And here I have two sample virtual hosts. In your case, this path may look different. In my case, I also need to open this file with the administrator privileges, so that I am able to make changes to it. In your case, you can probably open it like I'm doing now, and make changes to it. I can't do it because I am on Linux. I need to open this file with the administrator privileges. So in my case, I'm doing this in this way. I provide my password, and since now I am able to write to it. Based on these examples, I'm going to create my own virtual host, and I only need two lines from this. This I'm not going to use. Email address is also not necessary. I only need the path to the public folder. In the public folder, there is an index.php file, and the server is going to look here. And I will also need the name of the URL, like here, example.com. Regarding this name, I can name it as I want, for example, symph4crud-log. But here I need to provide the path to the public folder, so I will go to the folder where Symphony is installed, and here the server is going to look. I'm going to open it with terminal to copy the path, and I'm going to go back to this file and paste here. Exactly this path, like so. And now I'm going to save this file, and let's see if I am able to go to this address. Here the web browser is trying to search this string in the Google. So let's give it HTTP, so that we have the full address. I accidentally turned off my internet, so let me turn it on. And I refresh again. This page is not found because I have to do one more thing. I also need to edit hosts file. In the Linux operating system, hosts file I have in etc folder, and this file I want to edit now. So I write sudo gedit. If you work on different system, for example Windows or Mac, hosts file may be located somewhere else. And in this file I need to assign local address to my new domain, which I defined in the virtual host. So symph4crud-log. I save it and close. And it is not going to work yet. As we can see, the old xampp webpage was shown, not my to-do list app in Symphony. I also need to restart xampp, but I have xampp installed on the Linux, so I have to do one more thing. It may not be necessary for you. I need to change one more file. If you work on Windows or Mac, you probably don't have to do this. So let's try refresh the page. If you have to-do list application shown, then it's okay, but if not, then you have to do one more thing. So I will go to my xampp folder, and I'm going to edit the following file. HTTPD file. So I'm gonna open the console here. And I'm going to find in this file the string of virtual hosts. I have to uncomment this line. Exactly this. This is the virtual host file that I created. In my case, this is commented out, so I have to uncomment this. And save this file. I'm gonna close this, and now I'm going to restart Apache server. Before restarting Apache, it doesn't work. But after restarting Apache, my application should finally work. I'm waiting a while. And my Symphony application is installed with the local URL address.